So a man pulls out an AR style gun on a black landscaper. And here's the video, and I got background too. Here's video.
This is my property. You are not allowed to block my driveway.
I said I moved.
You think I'm playing?
Yeah.
Punk ass.
Yeah.
Your daughter better take record of how stupid her father is.
Yeah. All right.
Keep recording.
All right.
If it goes online, your ass will be sued too.
Cut that. Dude, you ain't got it. That.
That's it. I ain't got nothing.
That's what I said.
I'm telling her to cut this off. I'm telling her to cut this
you
off.
You think I ain't got nothing?
Well, record. You record. You pulling a gun on a guy in the middle of, on the city property. Listen. Do whatever.
I am going to do whatever. This is my property.
So damn shame. I got all the background. I have all of the information. I'm going to bring it to you forefront now. Let's put up the picture of the victim here. Okay. He's a landscaper. This is one of the victims, Jeremy Lee. Mr. Lee, who was cutting grass in Clear Lake, Florida, was with his daughter, teenage daughter, teaching her the business. Her name is Carrie Lee. She's also a victim. Resident David Berry, the man you saw waving his gun, became irate because Mr. Lee was partially blocking his driveway with his trailer. So obviously, this calls for you to come outside with the gun and wave it at a teenager and her father. Okay? How Carrie Lee saw things when the exchange started in the video, Lee's landscaping trailer does not seem to be blocking the driveway, but when the gate for the trailer was down temporarily to load out the lawnmower, it went near the resident's driveway on the street in front of it, causing him to become enraged, and he started cursing at the landscapers. Now, what's happening here? Okay, he pulls up, he's doing his job, he's on the street, and there is nothing blocking the driveway. When you open up the back of the trailer in order to unload the equipment, it partially now blocks a part of the driveway. That problem is resolved once you close the gate back. So let me show you a picture of David Berry. All right. I got a lot of information on this cat. David H. Berry. He works for Fat Finger Construction in Clearwater, Florida. He also has a lengthy criminal record, including several felony arrests. In the past, Mr. Berry there has been charged with at least three felonies, as we know, including battery, burglary, according to a county court record. He pled down all of his felonies to misdemeanors. Did you hear me? He was able to plea all of his felonies to misdemeanors. Berry told the police that he retrieved his weapon after Lee threatened him, which is 100% untrue. But the landscaper denied the accusations and said he was shocked that Berry thought it was necessary to produce a firearm, especially in front of his daughter. I was really worrying about her, he told NBC8. I was stunned. I'm like, are you serious? I think I said, you're going to kill me in front of my daughter? Lee did end up calling the police. The Clearwater Police Department arrived. Jeremy called them. But Berry, Mr. Berry, had already put his gun away. Carrie said the video shows the cops standing across the street, not taking any action at all. Even though the police were shown the video and told what happened, Carrie said they were told there was nothing that could be done. This is the Clearwater Chief of Police. His name is Daniel Slaughter. This is what he said about the events that took place. We are actively investigating this incident and we'll be presenting the case to the office of the state attorney. What? The police, they go lock people up. That's what they do. Okay? It's on video. At least you got menacing. Okay? Terroristic threat. Go ahead and arrest them. Because I guarantee you, if the black male would have pulled out an AR style weapon on the white male and did exactly the same thing, somebody would have had a jail stay that night. The bottom line is, according to the chief, bottom line is, it's a dispute over parking, should never have escalated to something like this. If you have a problem with someone partially blocking the driveway, you call the police. You don't grab a gun like some vigilante. Okay, great, chief. Now tell your men to go lock his ass up. You see, he's been getting away with felonies for years. You know what kind of cat this is. Let's get to it, chief. Stop with the wordplay and having no action behind it. You have the authority, you have the jurisdictional authority to say that's a crime and I'm going to have him arrested today. You don't have to wait for the state attorney general. You don't have to wait for that. All right, Doc, thoughts on this?
Yeah, I mean, these are the racial politics of stand your ground laws, of open carry. I think you're exactly right that we have 300 years of history in this country leading up to this moment that codes white men as patriots or protectors and black men as criminals or gangbangers or threats. And so the race of the guy holding the AR-15 really matters to the outcome. I think we see this again and again and again. And of course, this isn't the only white man who's acted like this. You can think about the couple, the McCloskeys in Missouri, for example, during Black Lives Matter protest, and many, many, many other examples. Now, the terrifying part about it is, I don't know, I study gun policy, and given the loose gun laws, when people feel threatened, pulling out your gun is actually legal in Florida and in Texas and in many other parts of the country and maybe the entire country thanks to the Supreme Court recent decision. And so in a way, this kind of racial politics of who gets to pull out their gun, we have a lot of data. A lot of the data comes from Florida that black people are the most likely to get shot in stand your ground kind of interactions. And so I think the race of guns and who codes as a gun owner is important. And I think the other important point, of course, is with so many more guns in our country, everyday interactions turn lethal and potentially fatal. So I know we talk a lot about mass shootings, but road rage and partner violence and accidental shootings, those are also forms of racial violence as we're seeing as well. So many angles here just illuminating the problem that more and more parts of this country are in right now because of guns.
Very well said.